My name is Arni Aromaa. I'm an industrial designer. My background is in Aalto University. Today we are about 30 designers with different backgrounds from industrial design to service design, concept development and so on. We always aim for results that would provide better every day for the end users and for the ordinary people. And then of course the other dimension is that we always aim to develop competitive advantage for our direct customers. And then what has become increasingly important during the past few years is the sustainability in all of its forms, that we always aim for lasting design. We can do clever choices in materials and we can do all sorts of good things, but I think that the single most important thing to do is to try to design things so that they would be as long-lasting as possible. Generally, if we think about the use of materials and the design process, there are several ways to achieve a more optimum result. One is simply trying to reduce the amount of the material used, use less material, aim for long-lasting design when away from the very short life cycle products, so that the material stays in the product then for longer. Especially when it comes to plastics, we try to look for options that are not fossil based but are renewable, from renewable sources. And there is a lot of pressure to put on designers saying that you should design products and into a more sustainable manner, and it's your responsibility to make the world more sustainable. And I think that there it is impossible for a designer alone to make any change. And I think in this respect, it's of course important that we have customers who are willing to take in use the new materials, the new solutions, who are open for these type of sustainable solutions. But then we need players like UPM who really can commercially and technically provide a material that is also then suitable for the mass production. And that is the only way actually to make the real impact, that it is not alone the designer's vision that changes anything, but we need the consumers who are interested in, and then we need all the partners and players who really make it happen. The very recent project where we have used the UPM material is for a client called Mysoda. Their products are home carbonators that are typically manufactured in fossil-based plastics. And during the material selection process, then we came across with this Formi EcoAce by UPM, which proved to be like technically very good. And then furthermore, it improves the aesthetics of the product at the same time. That it gives a very nice high quality surface that is then actually unique in every product, because the flow of the material is slightly different always, even though it's fully mass-produced, and then you see the flow of the wood chips in slightly different in every single product. At least based on this recent project, I think that there was we didn't have to do any compromises if we think that we would have used a fossil-based material. I think it's an area where the general trend is strongly working for them. And what is the great thing about the UPM material is that it is almost 100% wood-based. That also those parts that make it act like plastic are actually wood-based. And that is, I think, the great big thing that we can say, that it's basically 100% wood-based. But of course, the designers need to have the, let's say, the right mentality, the commitment to look for a more sustainable solution. And then from one hand, they need to be informed enough of the new possibilities, and we need to be curious enough for looking at the new options that we could use. And then combining these two so that they are also appealing both for the direct customer, for the retailers and for the end customers.